Good morning, viewers. This is Sufi, and face to face with me is Ali Mehndi, who is a Congress, I mean, young man for the Congress regiment, and he has worked for the Congress for a long time, like his father, and he's the president of minority at this point in time, Delhi Pradesh. So, because as we know, like, the Congress is literally in the ICU at this point in time. People call like it's ventilator. It's very difficult to return to either to the state or to the center. So let's find out how the situation is moving. We'll talk about the whole scenario in Uttar Pradesh. We'll talk about Delhi. We'll talk about the election recently held. So I want to just tell you something as to how this journey happened. I mean, how did you get into this Congress regiment? And you, since you are, you know, spearhead the minority young youth, so how did you get into it, like?
See, I've got a family background of politics. My father was in politics. But then in 2002, I was involved in the university elections, student politics. Then from, because we have a student union, that is National Student Union of India. So I was working as a karyakarta for NSUI. Then I became General Secretary for Delhi NSUI. Then I was continuously working. Then Mr. Rahul Gandhi came and he became the in charge of NSUI and Youth Congress. We were working as a team with him as a karyakarta. Then I'm very grateful to Mr. Rahul Gandhi, and because of his vision, because he promoted youth into Youth Congress and he promoted youth everywhere. Because of his thought, I became the chairman of minority department, and I'm the youngest chairman in India. I was 30 when I became the minority chairman. So I believe that it is because of Shri Rahul Gandhi. It is because of his the way he think about youth, the way he want Indian politics to go, the revolution he has that has come into the Indian politics, in Congress especially, that more and more youth has come into the picture. So because of him, I became one.
So because NSUI, that's been, you know, wiped out from Delhi University, is nowhere to be seen at this point in time now. So how do you look at you know, those young components to unite together and fight against this tyrant?
See, we didn't wipe out. I respect your words, but we didn't wipe out. I contend this, that we wiped out. NSUI didn't wipe out for last 2 years. Yeah, I can say that for last 2 years. Like, we are not getting that much of seats. But I want to remind you, like, it was six years before when NSUI got 4 seats in Delhi University elections, and ABVP lost miserably. It was BJP who said on record that we don't have any connection with ABVP. We don't know who they are. They are not connected with us. We lost the election, but Congress never said that we don't have any connection with NSUI. So this is the difference. It happens. We respect the what students like has given us, but the ratio and the percentage of vote what NSUI got last year, that has increased last year. So now we are working on that. We are working with these. But there were some problems. Like, I personally think that we were not reaching to the students as we should have. But now we have planned properly. Now we are planning. We are having meetings. Like, the NSUI president is having meeting with the minority department also, with the SC department also, with Youth Congress also. And now we are planning, because the elections are slated in September this year. So now we are having regular meetings how we should get back the student to Congress.
Okay, we have lots of talks to talk about. So far as, you know, like, when Delhi is concerned, like, we have, what went wrong, you know, at the bottom line? Because in the assembly, like, it's licking wounds, you know, it's not coming to power in any ways. And the party that has no, you know, background earlier on, and all of a sudden it emerged on the surface. I'm talking about AAP, I mean, right? So Aam Aadmi Party is there. But anti-incumbency, if you look at the other side of it, anti-incumbency factor was there. And of course, like, because in long 15 years, the Congress has worked like anything. Infrastructure has improved, everything has come up. Under the leadership of Mrs. Dixit. But what went wrong at the 11th hour, the party that has no background, you know, came to, you know, rule Delhi? So what went on there?
See, there were two, three reasons. I personally believe, I don't know about, I mean, it is the take of the party also, but personally, if you're talking to me, I believe that firstly, it was anti-incumbency. We were there for 15 years. Secondly, we were not connected with the people of Delhi in last years, mm-hmm. as we should have. Mm-hmm. That was the reason.
Yeah, I'm sorry to interfere out here. And anti-incumbency means like people are not happy in a way, they're annoyed. With the state governance in a way. The governance was not good, whatever. Because anti-incumbency means the people are not happy in a way. What went wrong was like people did not like the very idea of Mr. Dixit running the government in Delhi. This is what happened.
No, that can be the reason. That's what I'm telling you. There was some problem in connecting with the people. Mm-hmm. There was some problem mm-hmm. in connecting with the people, and our problem was we didn't advertise what we have done. Mm-hmm. You have to believe one thing, that whatever Delhi has become.
But your work is the advertisement itself, you see.
No, but people, see, Aam Party, I'm talking about Aam Party because you have told about Aam Party that they have emerged. Mm-hmm. Okay, they have emerged and people have given them the mandate. Mm-hmm. People have given them the proper mandate. It is the historical mandate which people have given. But Congress, the anti-incumbency came after 15 years. Mm-hmm. But what happened to Aam Aadmi Party? Mm-hmm. The anti-incumbency came within 2 years. What is the problem? The problem is of governance. Mm-hmm. See, when people come, they rule the state or they rule the country. Mm-hmm. But there is some problem with the governance. Mm-hmm. They don't know how to govern. Mm-hmm. I completely agree with you that there were some problems. That's why we were wiped out. Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. Now people are talking about Congress. Mm-hmm. Now everyone in the hook and corner are saying that it was Congress who was better than Aam Party and BJP. Reason being, because we have the we were working. Okay, problems were there, but we have the intention to work. Whatever the situation was, but we have intention to work. Aam Party, they don't have the intention to work. You tell me one word in my Aam Aadmi Party.
I draw a line saying that whatever you say is absolutely right to an extent, but what happened, what went wrong, that the Congress was rejected outright.
What I'm saying. Congress was rejected, and because we didn't connect with the people. But now there are scrutinies going on
But the Congress is sitting disowned, repudiated.
I come to that point.
One more thing.
That is the perception of media. Sorry to say this, but I respect media. And I respect because face media house, they are very liberal, they show the right news, but respecting all other media houses also, but I must tell you one thing. See, our problem was we didn't advertise our work as our respected Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji is doing. I must tell you one thing, people are saying, and I was, I heard that people were saying that Narendra Modi ji is saying that his man ki baat, tan ki baat, but there is no kaam ki baat. So kaam ki baat is nowhere.
No, we'll
because he is advertising.
Exactly, Narisa. We will talk about Maniye Pradhan Mantri Modi ji as well later. I mean, in the later part of the episode. But before that, I would like to know two things. Went wrong against the Congress to be holding the fortress intact. First, arrogance. Second, infighting within the party itself, right? Whether it's Jay Prakash Agarwal, he must have had some differences, some issues, some reservations against Madam, and she has some, maybe with her son or something like that. So these things mattered a lot on the platform.
Sir, actually, if you talk about internal politics, I don't know about what. See, if two big people are, they are talking to each other or they have some differences, that is a different story. But when we are...
No, this is not my version. I am speaking the tongue of the people.
No, might be. See, tongue of the people are saying many things. Mm-hmm. We have to concentrate on the positive aspect. There might be some problems going on. I have my constituency, Mustafabad. In my constituency, one corporator won this time. Okay, there might be some problems within the party workers. Mm-hmm. There might be some problems. There might be some issues with the party workers. That is the internal matter of any party. Mm-hmm. Like 4 days before, I heard about the news mm-hmm. that there is a rift between Manoj Tiwari and Mr. Goyal, who's mm-hmm. the sports minister. So it is everywhere. It happens everywhere. Mm-hmm. But when we are working under one umbrella, mm-hmm. we are working under the umbrella of Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi.
Exactly, but don't you think there are so many holes in the umbrella?
Look, see, there are. It happens everywhere. But I'll tell you one thing. Congress is not a new party. Yeah. It's the oldest party. If there are rifts between the leaders,
no, I'm talking about because I really respect. I really honor the credibility of the party. Being so old, you know, but still, you know, because the photo has slipped.
Sir, it happens everywhere. But and since the Congress is a very old party. Yeah. It's not the first time that rifts would have been there. Rifts were there, mm-hmm. but when the mandate of the people and the mind of the people is against you because of something, and I'll tell you one thing, I believe that 40% was the reason of our anti-incumbency and whatever you say, but 60% mm-hmm. were the what false mm-hmm. promises. Arvind Kejriwal mm-hmm. promised to the people of Delhi.
We'll talk about agenda, manifesto, and everything.
No, sir. But that is the reason. But I have to tell you the reason. What you are saying, I accept that, but I can't accept that 100%. Mm-hmm. 40%, I believe that was the reason. But 60%, mm-hmm. and now people have realized that was the 100% mm-hmm. reason mm-hmm. why Delhiites see. Mm-hmm. If there would have been an anti-incumbency. Mm-hmm. There should have been some opposition, mm-hmm. either it's BJP or whatever it is, mm-hmm. but AAM party got 67 votes. Mm-hmm. So that was the false promises made by Arvind Kejriwal. Mm-hmm. Arvind Kejriwal stood up to some house and he was disconnecting the electricity mm-hmm. Meter from there. Where is he right now? Mm-hmm. You see the problems going on? There is no electricity cut in Delhi is more than 4 to 5 hours in Delhi. Mm-hmm. Do you believe that now at this point of time we are living in the capital of this country? I don't believe. There is not a single work which has been done. The completion of the work which Sheila Dikshit has inaugurated, has been done.
No, actually we'll talk about, you know, like promises and lies later on, and we'll talk about as well what happened.
Sir, but I have to tell you the reason.
In the MCT, but on this very note, I would like to take a short break over there and I'll catch you back in just a bit.
लोग मुझे विलन कहते हैं, लेकिन पहचान बनाना एक दिन का काम नहीं, बरसों की मेहनत और लगन तब जाकर बनता है नाम। जैसे सर्वो कॉल 25 सालों के भरोसे के साथ भारत के सबसे बड़े सर्वो वोल्टेज स्टेबलाइजर निर्माता सर्वो कॉल रखे सब कंट्रोल में।
वेलकम बैक, अली मेहंदी, डीपीसीसी माइनॉरिटी चेयरमैन विद अस इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द माइनॉरिटी कमीशन एज वेल। So, I just want to reply in brief that way. So, what have you done for the minorities at this point in time?
See, it's been 2 years that I became minority department chairman of Delhi Pradesh Congress Committee by Shri Rahul Gandhi ji. And when I became the minority chairman, people had this in their mind that it is the department only for Muslims. So, in my first interview, NI people came to my office and I said, categorically I said, that this department is not only for Muslims. This department and minority as guaranteed by the Constitution of India, it is for the 6 communities in total, in which there are Muslims, there are Sikhs, there are Christian, there are Parsis, there are Jains and Buddhist. So I have tried my level best.
So do you have such instances? Such instances about these people coming to you? From other minorities.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Then Muslims.
That's what I'm saying. But when now, if you talk, because I'm talking to you 2 years before, when I just became, there was no team. But now, if you talk to me, I have Sikh in my team. I have Jains in my team. I have Christians in my team. Mm-hmm. Buddhists and Parsis are not in Delhi as such. So, but Sikh, majority of Sikh, Rajouri Garden and all these places, and even in Gandhinagar, they're connected with me. They're connected with me like I'm the medium, they're connected with the party. And I feel honored that I'm the medium for them to, you know, to make, to them to connect to the party. And one more thing I must tell you, because like it was 2 years before and it was Ramzan. Mm-hmm. We planned a very historical thing, which is, if I say historical, I feel very blessed that I was the part of it. I've organized a Roza Iftar inside the premises of Gurdwara, which was first time. And I wholeheartedly, you know, I thank the Sikh community, the people of Sikh community. It was not, you know, for us Muslims to go to Gurdwara and, you know, break our fast. But it was a big thing for the Sikh community to organize the Roza Iftar in Gurdwara.
Let's talk about iftar parties. You know, iftar parties are getting in the air these days, you know, for the past year or so. So that has become more political, I think.
See, I don't know about other parties, but Congress party, there is a culture for very long time. They have done it for, I don't know, it was before I came to politics. They have done it for long, long year. They are doing it, and we personally don't politicize it. We believe that the minority in this country, the Muslims, they should feel that we are, because we do it from within. We don't do it by keeping something like politics in mind. There is no politics in Congress. I don't know about anyone else. And see, I don't want to comment on any other party. Might be they're doing it.
Isn't that like when people, I mean, go to Roza Iftar party, so called, and they are being organized. They are being organized and managed by the non-Muslims. You know, they have one intention very clear. Is like they have the opportunity to, you know, photo opportunities. One of them, they rub shoulders, you know, with big wigs, it's like that, you know, so as to get into politics in a way or the other. They exchange their numbers and stuff like that. They have got nothing to do with the sanctity of the Ramzan, you know. So I mean, that's kept aside, I think.
Sir, but that is your perception, but I have a different perception, because I'm thinking a positive aspect out of it. See, you cannot, you know, get into someone and just see their intention, what is their intention. But for me, if you talk about the broader perspective, I believe that it is because India is known for the Ganga Jamuni Tehzeeb. And if a Hindu...
But that is also being politicized, you
sir, see. Sir, see, that is their intention. But publicly, and see, it is all about message also. What we do, I believe what we do, we should do, or we should keep our life as a message to the people at large. It's their intention, they knows, and God knows. You see, I am no one to interrupt in between, but I believe if a Hindu or a non-Muslim is organizing a Roza Iftar, you know, for Muslims, and everybody is coming there and, you know, rubbing shoulders and whatever it is, that spreads a very big message across the country and across the globe that, okay, this is the country where a Hindu is organizing a Roza Iftar for Muslims. I believe we should take it in a positive way.
So far as your take is concerned, so far as your take goes, you see, it's absolutely very clean and very pious and very holy, that way. But where is the point, and what is the point inviting, you know, political honchos, you know, or you know, IPS and people like that to that party? What does it mean? What means does it signal out?
See, the parties which you're talking about, I believe that media houses, you know, organize these kind of parties. And if anybody else also organize, where IAS and politicians, these people come, I don't think there is any problem in that. If they are coming, see, they are also the part of the society. Somehow they are also connected with us. If you're calling an IAS officer to a Roza Iftar party,
but he doesn't keep one.
No, see, that is a different story. Sir, that is a different story. But I'm not doing a puja in the Dashera. I was in Bombay. I was called by many people in pandals and at Ganpati. I'm not doing puja as Hindus doing. But I was being called because if I go there, there'll be a message that Hindu and Muslim, they are, you know, they are organizing, and they are organizing their festivals and they're together. See, it is all about message. The same thing which RSS doesn't want.
No, actually, Mahani sir, this is togetherness you're talking about, and secularism you're talking about is more political. What is?
Sir, see, again, I'll tell you, that is all about intention. We have to take it according to our mind.
No, I'm talking about what people think about.
So, you tell me one thing, sir. If there is an intention, if no Hindu is called, only Muslims are doing that. They can be, they can also be a political matter. If I'm calling any IS or politician or what whatsoever who is a Muslim and who has kept Roza, and I have this intention, I'm calling that person, reason being because, you know, I'll get we'll be very well connected and I'll get my work done. Mm-hmm. So that is also intention, because Allah says that when you're saying your namaz, when we say our namaz, and the niyat is very important. If there is no niyat, there is no namaz. So it is all about intention and your niyat, what you're doing. See, you are doing particular thing which is connected with religion, that is for Allah, for the God. And if your mind is diverted, then it is between you and Allah, you know, no third person can do anything.
I can understand this is a star party, a political thing or whatever it is, I'm telling you, is hotting up now. So we have to drop this very idea discussing further. Yes, there's one thing like, since, you know, Modi government, you know, at the center, and in other states, you know, 14 and 4 more, 18 states, right? So they have this, you know, landslide victory, you know, they have come to power with something majority that way. And they have completed, a couple of days back, you know, they have completed 3 years. So, what exactly have you seen? What they have done in these 3 years?
Sir, your question.
You have to be very short.
I'll be very with content and very short.
Very concise.
You're talking about the 18 states in which they are ruling. I'll talk about two states where Congress got 17 seats in Goa. I was the in charge of Goa. I was there for 15 days. We were in power, and it was because of the AM party. AM party went there and they got zero seats, but they have taken the votes from Congress, as Congress would have won. What BJP has done in Manipur and Goa, that is Gundaism. That is Gundaism, because
you have the sitting MPs.
No. We had 17 seats. I'll tell you, we have 17 seats. One NCP guy was with us, so we got 18 seats. We were like 3 MLAs less. Two from the government. No, three, because 21 should be the ratio there. But Nitin Gadkari ji or whosoever from BJP, they went to Goa, and they were 11. You tell me, they got 10 MLAs. Not even a single media house is asking BJP that you have done horse trading. They were in love with BJP. That those MLAs came to, they joined BJP and they helped BJP to form government.
No,
why?
But post trading.
In Manipur.
No, post trading in Goa was quite evident.
So, nobody, not even a single person I have seen in media, they are asking any BJP person that you have done horse trading. Not even a single person. There is no one in the country who is asking BJP that you have done horse trading.
No,
and what happened in Manipur? What happened in Manipur?
You were the CM there?
No. We would have got a CM there, but there was only two MLAs required there. They went there and they were bribing Congress MLA also. Similar thing they did in Arunachal Pradesh. There was a sitting Congress chief minister there. They went there and they did horse trading. So you tell me one thing.
Arunachal Pradesh was your constituency.
That's what I'm saying.
You have had the CM there. Then what went on?
Basically, we had the CM there. They went there and, you know, they said that we are in power. We will not give you money. We will not give you money for development. What will you do? I don't know what happened there. But this is sheer horse trading. On face of it. Then also nobody is ready to understand because the medium. The medium is biased. Sorry to say this. I'm really very sorry I'm saying this, but medium is biased. They are not showing BJP what they are. They are showing BJP only in a good mode. But I must tell you, from your channel, sorry to interrupt you, from Face channel, I must tell you this, that people of India, they are rising, they are awakening, they see whatever the media house have shown, but people now, they are realizing there is not a single upliftment in employment. Not even a single employment has given to anyone. What Modi ji has promised, that I'll give 1 crore employment every year, not one employment has been given. If you talk about the security of women, you see what is going on in UP, what is going on in the other lanes of India, other different cities.
So in these three years, the Modi government hasn't done anything. It's mere.
I'll tell you, sir, what Modi government has said. Modi government has done Man Ki Baat, but there was no Kaam Ki Baat till date. Only Man Ki Baat was there.
And what is the
no
Kaam
Ki
Baat?
We are expecting what they have promised. They have promised employment to the youth. They have promised security to the women. They have promised security to the downtrodden. They have promised security to the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, the minority, and all these people. They have promised their nara is sabka saath sabka vikas.
But they have
it is no no sir.
But they have Yogi in Uttar Pradesh. Whatever you want then.
So this is development. What do you think? This is development.
How do you look at it? Like?
Thank you for saying this, sir. They have given Yogi to us in Uttar Pradesh, and it has been 60 days that Uttar Pradesh is. You know what has happened in Uttar Pradesh? Uttar Pradesh is crying. You talk about Saharanpur, you talk about Aligarh, you talk about Bulandshahr 3 days before, you talk about Rampur 2 days before. A lady and her daughter were going for a morning walk, and suddenly goons appeared from somewhere, and they are saying they are molesting her, and they are making video on face of it. Where is the police? Yogiji has promised us.
So Gundaism is something that is
Gundaism
in Uttar Pradesh.
You can see, sir, what has happened in Alwar. The so-called Gau Rakshak. Mm-hmm. I mean, can you kill a person who has got an animal with a permit, with a proper license? You drag him outside and you kill him on the road.
I have got a point to make out here if you don't speak anything. My point is, because the Modi government has promised employment and cow vigilance, you know, they have recruited so many people, you know, guarding cow in the name of that. They've been, you know, harassing people, they've been, you know, lynching people. They have started doing this thing. So cow vigilance is one of the, you know, employment,
I completely agree with you. And there is a problem. Modi ji or BJP or RSS, they have supported Gau Rakshak, Gau Vigilant, whatever you say, okay? Gau ministers, I must say. Mm-hmm. Everyone is a minister of Gau, guy. And Modi ji, going through one of his lectures, he was saying that I am against these Gau Rakshak. I mean, I don't understand. What is this? What politics you are playing?
Yes,
you are somehow you are saying that I am against the Gau Rakshak. Mm-hmm. RSS and BJP are supporting the Gau Rakshak. Mm-hmm. So you are making a mockery and you are making fool out of this country, mm-hmm. the country people. But I must tell Modi ji from your channel that people of India are very intelligent. We are those people who are the IT professional in America, Saudi, or whichever part of the globe you say. So we you cannot make fool out of us. Yeah. Indians are highly emotional people. We are emotional. But we are not stupid. You can make us emotional. Because we are emotional, because we believe in God, we believe in Allah, we believe in Bhagwan. That's why we are emotional. But we are not fools. So this mockery, this all, you know, this whole the scenario what BJP has made, that has to come down. People will understand that they are only here to make this country. To remove the Ganga Jamni Tehzoob of this country, to remove the love what our ancestors has put in this country. This country is of Shri Ram, this country is of Khwaja Gareeb Nawaz, this country is of Tipu Sultan, this country is of those people who have died for this country.
Actually, my question earlier was like, I mean, in these 3 years, Modi government has done nothing except like he has given Yogi in Uttar Pradesh to rule the state that way, and in Delhi, like, nothing has moved further. So things are still at the same place where they started, right? So once you look at the elections coming up, so what do you think your strategy would be, and what mandate? I mean, what you call what agenda, what manifesto would be coming into the fray to fight this election?
Sir, we have a lot of agenda given by them, because what they are doing. See,
but they've been still enough.
Do you tell me one thing? They are saying Yogi government was saying that if we'll come to Yogi was saying also BJP was saying, when we'll come to power, we will eliminate, we will stop all these slaughterhouses in UP. But now they are saying that avaid buchadkhana and vaid buchadkhana. Illegal slaughterhouse is one in which one animal is being, you know, slaughtered. Legal slaughterhouse is one in which 1,000 animals are being slaughtered. But why Yogi government is, you know, quiet on that slaughterhouses? I must say this from your TV, from the Face TV, that if Yogi ji, he is very sattvic, he believes that I want to make the state very sattvic, anda should also be banned in UP. Why these slaughterhouses are open? Because there is a 20,000 crores market which is being run by slaughterhouse, and China is involved. That's why they cannot speak anything against slaughterhouses. I challenge them. Actually, you stop these slaughterhouses. No, why the slaughterhouses are there?
My question is to remain unanswered. My question is very fair to you, is that in election coming up, how do you look at it, and do you think that you will come back to power once again?
Definitely, sir. We will come back. How? I'll tell you.
Strategy, manifesto, their agendas, what?
Sir, manifesto, what are you talking about?
If I say Delhi IS do not like you coming to power, then what do you think, that you will be coming the other way around to major government there?
Sir, I'll tell you. As I said earlier, we were 9%, now we are 22%. So we are working on that context. And Ajay Makanji, because I'm working with him, I have not seen him a single day that he was, you know, sitting. Whatever the muddas we had against the Modi government.
But how about those bright faces and those big faces disappeared?
Face is the people of Delhi. We are making people of Delhi the face. The Karyakarta is the face of Congress. There is no single person in Congress who is the face. There is the Karyakarta.
But they should come out.
They are coming. I'm telling you, when we have come to 22%, so there are rifts. They were there in their constituencies. If you were talking about Lovely ji.
How do you plug those chinks coming in the party?
That will. In coming time, you will see that we are coming up with a more proper team, with a youth team, with a young team, with old people coming from backside. They'll be supporting the youth, and you will see the mixture of every kind of person, what was in Congress and what are joining Congress and what are coming to it. And we are, see, I'm not the strategy maker, but personally, I'm telling you, at what I can feel, that we have a plan to fight for the youth of this state, and we are fighting for the women of the state, for the Dalit and scheduled tribe, scheduled caste minority, and all other section of the society who are being downtrodden, who are being, you know, whose promise have not been kept. So we are fighting for them, and we will fight for them. Either Delhi will give us mandate or not, but we are committed to fight for the people of Delhi.
Tall claims. We are talking about tall claims, you know, lofty promises, you know.
So these are not promises.
No. You are able to retain your seat, or you are able to snatch your seat in Punjab. The rest of the seats, you know, 4 permanent seats, you had key seats, you know, you lost.
But two, I told you. Fine. No, that will be horse trading.
Horse trading, poaching, whatever. So that's no thing. My point is, in coming election in Rajasthan, you see, Gehlot is sitting there. Chauhan is sitting there.
Mr. Ashok Gehlot, he has been given the responsibility of General Secretary of Congress, and he has been.
Even in Madhya Pradesh, you see.
Madhya Pradesh will be fine. Now, there is no rift at all. You tell me, where is the rift? See, one person has to be made the state president. Only one can be made, and all other leaders, they are with him. It's not like what, I don't know what perception you have in mind, or what media have, but I'm telling you the reality. There is no problem at all, either in Madhya Pradesh, either in Rajasthan, Sachin Pilot, he's doing a good work.
He would have lost from Dosa.
Sir, had been is a different story.
He contested from the particular seat. He lost from Dosa, but we won
the municipal corporation election in Rajasthan during his tenure only. It is under his, sir. See, what has happened, that is a different story. Now, because we are positive people. But Vasundhara, so we have to follow. But, Vasundhara, there is an anti-incumbency within the BJP.
No, but it's going to return the seat. She is not the one to be leaving the fortress just like that only.
No,
she will. She'll be there.
These are our perceptions. These are perceptions. Sorry to say this, but these are perceptions.
You will see
once elections are, when elections will be there, you will see how Congress will come into power.
I kept on
in
so many Rajasthan. People, so many people, you know, I mean, have you met congressmen and all this thing? They spoke the same, language and all this thing. At the end of the day, nothing happened, you see.
So people rejected, I tell you, I was asking the media people that what will happen in Goa. They were saying that you will not get a single seat and AAM party will get 15 seats.
No, actually,
but we got more seats there.
No, actually my answer would have been that the Congress would win over there. I'm sure about it. And I was pretty sure about it. Something else happened there, there's something else. But Veer Bhadra Singh, Raja Veer Bhadra Singh, like he's going to be raised from the seat.
No sir, it is all plotted by the BJP.
Mm-hmm.
You tell me that he has got the bail. The verdict is not final. We have to wait till the verdict at least.
Mm-hmm.
He has not been charged.
Mm-hmm.
He has not been charged. Case is going, that is a different story.
Mm-hmm.
But he has not been charged.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to wait till the case
comes
to the conclusion.
Mm-hmm.
So then only we can, you know, comment on that.
So it's wonderful talking to us,
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
This was Ali Nadi Saab, DPCC minority chairman. Recounts the whole story as to how the Congress could make a comeback to the city of Delhi as well as the center. With video journalist Bilal Ansari, this is Sufi for Face to Face.